Hey, good morning and welcome to 2023. I hope you're all doing amazing, ready for a kick butt year.
Holy crap.
So, we're back with Fallout 76. It's a brand new year. I took down all the art behind me. We're going to be redoing the whole wall. Do one more art. That's the goal, right? Have an epic year. I hope you guys are all going to have an amazingly epic year. Sure, you're gonna do big things, right? I think so. I'm gonna get chat up real quick so I can see what's going on. It's always a good idea, right? Okay. Oh, there's atomic shop stuff. Do we want to see if it actually changed? Some New Year stuff. You know, guys, I'm going to be honest. This alien invader thing right there, I kind of do want it. I'm not going to grab it right this second. But let's be honest. It's a temptation. Making sure I got everything. Okay, we're just going to go in. I think one day this week, we're going to check out those other modes. Like that builder thing and whatever. Just to check them out. I haven't actually seen them. I have them as an option with that Fallout First stuff. No idea what they are, actually. So, big things this year, right, guys? Everybody's gonna do something big? Knock off a goal or something, I hope. Knock off a bunch of goals. I don't know where I am. This weekend, I actually did start playing a little bit, like, you know, just messing around. How are we overweight? Okay, well, we're right at a train station. It doesn't even matter. I just want to see where I left. Oh, okay, that's why we're overweight. I don't know why. I'm not awake yet, guys, just to be honest. Not even gonna pretend. In fact, normally I wake up at least an hour before my stream. Not so much today. Guys, we're at 2,500 magic item points. That's pretty freaking good. Okay, so we've got stuff going on. Let's see what our dailies are. Collect some script. This is gonna be easy. Let's go gold stars, pick a lock, right? Okay. Ah, the photo mode crap. Okay. We're still overweight. Oh, we're still overweight. Okay. I'm just getting us down in weight and figuring out exactly why we're so overweight. Probably 41 freaking runaways. Hey, I hope you're having a great morning. And I hope you have an awesome year, man. Do some epic stuff. I don't even know what big thing you got planned, but I hope you knock it out of the park this year. I have a high confidence that we're all about to do amazing. Just gonna say. I'll throw that one in your side of the court where it's already assumed that you're going to do something up this year, so you might as well do it. Okay, so we don't need 41 Radaways. That's excessive. Oh, I'm planning epic stuff this year. I don't even know what all's happening this year, but it's going to be big, and I'm going to make it that way, period. Like, you know what I'm saying? Whatever it takes to figure out how to make things epic. Actually, I think the universe wants things to be epic for most people anyway, to be honest. But, you know what I'm saying? As a whole, contextually, I don't think the whole of things is against people necessarily. Okay. I don't think we even need to go here except to get more stakes. So let's... Oh, and drop off crap. Never mind. I do need to go there, guys. Ooh. Starting off with excellent coffee that was not too hot, was not too cold. You know, once you start drinking coffee, you understand that mama porridge, baby porridge thing a little bit better, huh? I was just thinking that. Sometimes it is just too hot. Sometimes it is too cold. And sometimes it is just right. You guys did not know you were going to hear that kind of crap today. Okay, so, by the way, I'm getting excessive materials at this point. If you guys are needing black titanium for something, or probably pretty much anything at this point, because, like, what the crap am I going to do with 2,000 units of that or this? Or you guys should just let me know. Probably have an excessive amount of it. Okay. We're going to come over here. We're going to kill my Deathclaw. Right off the bat, I always like to have a Deathclaw kill. That's just some dudes over there that are shooting at the Deathclaw. They're gonna get themselves killed anyway. Where did he go? Right there. Okay, that dude didn't hostile on us, so I'm not killing him, but I am gonna go kill these dudes over here, okay? Because they're hostile too, and he'll get his butt kicked because I accidentally killed his people. Because I thought it was some of these dudes. We have different spawns that walk by the camp. Okay. See what I mean? We start off fast. Boom. Get our steak. So, if you guys don't know, normally Deathclaw steaks give you 2 strength. I have the carnivore mutation. It doubles the benefit you get for meat type buffs. And so, carnivore lets you basically get better amounts of strength, so you get 4 strength instead of 2. Super handy to, you know, not be weak basically. I have a chef outfit we accidentally got, you guys. I'm legitimately... Good morning, by the way. I hope you're having an amazing day too. You ready to start the year out and kick some butt? I'm sure you are. I'm hoping that a lot gets sorted out in this universe and world this year, and that we all can start trending towards a more dynamic, happy world where we're not having as much silly crap going on and much more just amazing. I'm going to do this fly swatter event even though I don't like it that much, because we're going to get these dailies knocked out like that. And honestly, I don't remember what the fly swatter event is partially why. I know it's right over by that town of Welch that we like. So I get to kill those people. That's a good thing. But this event, I don't remember. Is it even where I think it is, guys? This isn't by Welch. Nah, this is not the one I thought it was. It's cool. Okay, where's this thing I'm supposed to do? Destroy a Vertibot? Are you serious? Hold on, guys. I gotta get stuff out for destroying. I don't even have an aerial weapon. You know what I'm saying? It's okay. Who just shot me? Okay, we're gonna have to get out an actual gun. I don't know what keeps shooting at me, but it's about to make me annoyed, and we're gonna deal with that too in a minute, but that's its own thing. Yeah, that's what we're gonna go with. I was debating between the vampiric version or that. That was literally a problem, you know what I mean? I hear stuff after us. I'm not dealing with the crap that's like a distraction right this second. What mutated? What the crap even could mutate on us? An aircraft? I've got a mutated vertebrate, guys. If he really would come down like that, I will just zap him. That was not exactly what he should have done. Why would you do that? I didn't know this guy was trying to mess with us too. Okay. I think we got it, guys. Tomorrow, I'm gonna make us a magic bow today. I'll bet I have 9 levels. Tomorrow, I'm gonna be a freaking archer. Nah. I see this dude down here. Oh, guys, you know how many of these holiday gifts we have? I haven't been opening. Holy crap. I have fire intent again. There's my tent. Okay. A5. Probably could sell more of this stuff, to be honest, guys. But let's see if we can get down to weight just off of this. Not a chance. Okay. Oh, that multi-purpose axe I freaking don't need. It's what happens when you're not paying attention, guys. Dudes rush you out of nowhere. That didn't really do it for us. Guys, I don't need the Gatling gun right this second. Let's just drop it off. What the crap? I have random other stuff. Okay, that's what's overweightness. Let's get rid of that. Gatling gun's still not helping though. Okay. Okay. Now we're ready for next adventure. Let's find another target. Frank, more people need to go to Project Paradise, guys. Crap, that's one of the fun ones. Okay, we're waiting to see if people are gonna go there. Which is not really looking like it. So soloing Project Paradise sucks, guys. And so that's not something I'm really trying to get us into. But I'd really like to do Project Paradise, so if people like go there, it would be helpful. Let me look at what our challenges are. Drink Nuka-Colas. That's easy. Okay. Now I am going to go kick some butt for us. I'm going to just go kill something big for a second. Ah, nah. Not good. What is... Another person's there. That's enough for me. Two people? Yeah, that's not a real good choice, but... I'm going to tell you, we're going to do it. And now that somebody will see two of us are here, they'll be like, there's two people there. Three people, we got this. Okay, somebody's gonna initiate the experiment. I'm waiting a second to give like 20 more seconds for somebody else to get here in case. I know, great music though. Feels like a dentist office.
Project Paradise is now.
Okay, we're doing it. Where'd that dude go? I was gonna get them up. This is such good XP, guys, by the way. I just heard something coming at me. I didn't know what it was. Okay. This might be enough for this one. Where is he? Okay, so that one's done, right? No, it's at 3. Or 1. Okay, so I need a bunch more venison. Or should we move on to the others? I don't think I'm gonna get this done, guys. Cause it's only me and that other person. I'm coming for that. Good morning, Firebug, how you doing? Hope you're ready for an amazing year. I know you're gonna have one. You're still hitting the gym and everything. I'll bet your year's gonna be epic. So I'm still trying to get my feet, so. Where's this person that's down? Okay, we got this. I don't know what we're doing with that, but yeah, no, it's going to be a good year, you guys. I feel everybody should have big goals, and then because we're going to hit our goals this year. I don't even know how big my goals should be. You know what I'm saying? Oh, these dudes are beast. I feel that we're probably in trouble on this. Looks like there's a bunch of dudes over there now. Maybe we're not in as much trouble as I think. I hit this thing. Oh, that would be insane. That would be an awesome goal. That's next level. I know mathematically That's probably not gonna happen, but I'm gonna do bigger things this year than I've ever done any you before, for sure. I don't even know what all. But I got a mining HOF last night on Cyrene on my very first drop after landing, so that's not bad. Did we just fail this? No. Where did that thing go? There was just a bug chasing that. I don't know if we're gonna succeed at this. These ants in the ground? Oh yeah, it was very cool because it was stuff I needed too. And so I'm excited for today's stream. It's gonna be a fun Cyrenian type. Whoa, did somebody just try to vaporize me? Yeah. Okay. I'm gonna tell you guys, this chainsaw, it is just game changing in every way. Like, I felt my guy was comfortably where I was liking him before I got this. And I'm gonna tell you, this absolutely has changed. What's a friendly animal? That doesn't look friendly. Yeah, super excited about that. I, by the way, did make that twin sword off of Tolan, the poison. And I took it to Cyrene to use in hunting. Actually, I have a lot of weapons on Cyrene. Yeah, it's gonna be fun. That's what one of the things I'm looking forward to. Well, this stuff was not hardcore. We need to get over to the other side. It's waves. Never mind. You're safe, little bug. They're ditching our little bug. Where is he? I'm not ditching him. I know how this works. We don't let him die. Crap, I'm gonna have to go over here. That's not one of our friends. Regarding this bug, yeah, I'm... Whoa. Cockroach on the ground.
Observation. Once consumed, Formula P incites aggression in nearby animals who have not also consumed Formula P. This can lead to fighting and death.
Well, that's not sounding good, but... Yeah, there's a... Man, I don't even know. I'm gonna hire healers for the first time this year as a more often thing, though. I'm killing these guys. I see that they're incoming. I like the timely music that kicked in right there. What just got that guy's leg? This is so much XP. Okay. Well, what I'm wanting to do is, because I actually have the Sky Wraith summoning and all that stuff, is I was going to get healers and stuff for summoning bigger, some of the bigger, funner stuff on Siren. That would have, well, it doesn't have to be taken down with groups, but like... Some of the stuff would be funner in a group. You know what I'm saying? Like the big bird, probably going to be funner in a group. I don't even know about the Sky Wraith blah 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 that we have the ability to summon yet. Because I've never summoned it. That looks like it's alive, right? Yeah. Well, and that's why we'd be like, hey, we need people on this. So basically, by bigger things, more things that we need more people on that would be more social. In which that means I'm going to have to be better this year about arranging stuff. Which, you know, that I'm okay with. But yeah, it sounds like a better year to do more socially stuff. And so, basically, you know, that's the concept. Which, there's a lot of social stuff to do in that game. Plus, I'm going to show everybody the like, little ways you can level fast and stuff like that there. Which, by fast leveling, I mean, let's just be honest. Leveling is what it is in Entropia. And so, well, you're sure for sure being invited. I don't know if these guys know about this staircase. I really like this music today for some reason. Okay, now. Yeah. So, yeah, so that's the thing. That's the trick to it, right? So, anything that you're miserable at is a horrible, horrible grind. I don't care what you're doing. If it's miserable, it's not gonna seem like it's going fast. But if you're just sitting there chilling and actually having fun with what you're doing, it's gonna seem like it goes faster because you're having fun. And so, a lot of Entropia leveling is finding stuff you actually like doing in the game to where you're able to, or chip in. Yeah, and I'm not going to argue that. That's an absolute valid way to level. But, reality-wise, if you're just trying to, like, hey, I would like to be high level one day, you need to find stuff that you like doing so you can do it every day. Or more, not every day. Doing stuff every day is not a real great idea. Like, doing different stuff is. I don't like to burn myself out on things. And so I like to have a variety of stuff I do. Yeah, no, it is how you look at it. But I like a little bit of mix-up in Entropia, you know, just because that way, because you're going to be playing Entropia for years and years. It's not like some games where you can raid the same location again and again and again because you're only going to be playing the game hardcore for, what, a month, 6 months, something like that in most cases. And so, like, with Entropia, it's a you're playing it 16 years later game type stuff. And so, everybody's different. I mean, some people aren't planning on playing it 16 years later. I have played it for a long time. I plan on still playing it for more time than I already have played it. And so, for me, I want to just make sure I keep it fun, sustainable for myself, and to where it's a good, pleasant, positive environment for me to be in. You know what I mean? Like, and that's the biggest thing. That's the other thing that makes Entropia so sustainable, is that you don't have a massively toxic environment in which, because toxic environment, toxic game environments, how long are you honestly going to stay in a game in which the people are repetitively just naughty? No, I don't think that people cashing out is going to kill the game. I've read their 10K reports and stuff like that off of their stock data. The average date that people play, the amount of time, isn't actually that long. So 80% of the volume of people that are going to play Entropia are going to play for only a specific amount of time. They're going to deposit on average, and Entropia in their data, they know how much money on average people deposit, and they know the different groups, right? So your big 80% group is actually only going to play for like not even a year, to be honest. And on average, they only deposit about $16 for that small group that plays. It's a big group of people plays short term, right? And only deposits about $16. And it changes every year. I haven't read it for this year. And so, but when I did read it a couple years ago, they had no risk in their model. Like, they didn't have, their model is good. So for one, they're basically a bank anyway. Which makes them like required to bow down to all that financial stuff too. But their model, you're not going to have people to withdraw enough for the amount that they've already made. And they'll continue to make. I mean, they would have to have a report that indicated that they were dead on new subscriptions, which could happen, guys. I mean, like, not going to say it couldn't, but we should all notice, like, seriously notice. And then on top of that, you have, besides that, you have this insane market of, I mean, they've got a lot of people's money in a secured manner. Like, I wouldn't worry about that part. I worry about major infrastructure attacks against them or something else that could critically damage them because the nature of what they are. Like, I'd be more worried on an external thing. Financially, their business is a good model. But they deal in large volumes of money. And it is what it is, guys. I don't think that there's necessarily like a direct threat against them right now. But if there was some kind of large scale cyber activity or a bunch of other scenarios, that could be a serious threat. But that'd be a threat to tons of companies, just so you guys know. Not even just this game. This game is down on the list of where the threats would probably start. We're just cooking up some food and dropping some stuff off. I'm gonna see if I have the area thing. Hey, how you doing? I'm gonna probably make you some weapons, okay, bro? Dude that's War and Peace. I think I have my thing set to where he could hear me, but I'm not sure. Okay. I feel that new people benefit. Long-term players have the most benefit. For sure. For one, you're actually getting, well, for tons of reasons. Your stats are beneficial. You're killing things that are able to be killed only by people that are higher level. Hey, Warren, bro, I'm going to put some weapons over here, or any of you guys. It's going to be tomahawks, okay? Why isn't it going over there? That stash isn't full. Hey, guys, I'm dropping them on the ground, dude. The thing's not working right for some reason. Here. That makes me mad when things don't work right. We're going to drop them that 50 caliber machine gun. 12 plasma grenades. We're going to drop those. Some tomahawks. They probably need all that stuff more than me. I'm gonna drop some of this stuff. Oh, I was trying to drop it, not do that. Can I tell you, there's only a few people I can think of that have done really good as non-depot players. Okay, dude, there should be some stuff up here in here real quick. Or maybe you already grabbed it, I don't know. Right there, in that bag. Yeah, so, I know some people that were real good at non-depot playing. And they have done very well for themselves. Have they done as well? Probably not, you know what I'm saying? But it doesn't matter, like, how big a creature you're hunting. It matters if you're, like, fulfilling your own enjoyment in the game. Honestly, too many people, in my opinion, and this is 100% opinion, guys, literally obsess too much about the idea of the fact that they're going to make money and stuff, which you obsess about that too much in real life. You know what I'm saying? Like, I also like to economically play. I also don't like to extend large amounts of my resources into stuff for no reason. But at the end of the day, I'm much more concerned about how much fun I'm having playing a game than the other stuff. And so if you don't get into the whole trap of feeling like you aren't having a good time because you're not the most powerful avatar in a game, then you'll have more fun. Like, they're playing the game differently than me, maybe. There are a lot of avatars more powerful than me. I'm cool with that. I'm like, literally, they've dedicated more physical resources to the game, time, and so they're higher level. I play the game to the maximum I desire to play all the time. And that hasn't... Oh, that's the wrong weapon. What the crap did we switch to that? Guys, don't do that. I pulled out a random pipe there like I was going to menace this... That would have been interesting, though. I'll bet I lost. Nah, I wouldn't lose. Oh, I'm not in my armor, guys. Oh, what am I doing? I'm over here messing with this dude, not in armor or anything. I took off our armor. Sorry, guys. Hold on. But, nah, dude. Find the zone of contentment with happiness with your gameplay over all that other crap, for sure. Like... But the people that I know that have made the most money in there play it very investment style, just so you guys know. Like, they play the crap out of it. And so I'm not trying to, like, diminish, oh, well, they hardly play. Nah, they play it. But I can tell you that one of my buddies, the guy that loaned me my Pyro 1 chip, he... was free to play for the longest freaking time. And he literally grinded and swanted on the Kaborias on Arcadia, then went over to Toulon. And he did Toulon for a really long time. And then after Toulon, he decided that he was going to, basically, he bought a lot of AUDs and stuff like that over his time. And by the time he even started depositing, which he did start depositing for a while, his investments flipped around his stuff. He absolutely does not need to deposit. Because his play does not exceed his actual returns. But the thing is, he still deposits. Like, he still, right now, can play to the maximum amount of his actual, like, desire off of what comes in from his deeds. And yet, right now, I know that even though he's just gaining, he's still depositing, not a ton, guys, but he does deposit still. But he mostly still is legit, buys like ammo packs, and then when he's done with that, he just takes and transfers that over into deeds. And so, but he played years grinder mode, like grinding like mad, like to the point that I even thought, holy crap, man, you are grinding the crap out of this. I don't know if you guys remember when Billy's Bar was a thing. But Billy's Bar used to have a situation where you could go to, what is it called? It, basically. Hunt the thing. Sorry, not yet. Hunt the thing, and you could grab one of the little M16s in there and the weird ammo. And then you would go to Billy's Bar, and you'd wait till the mob spawned in the instance, and you would spray it over them, hitting three mobs in a single spray over, because it was and it would put 1 point on each mob. Now those mobs only have like 2 life or 3 life or something like that, and so first, like, you could grind it, get tons of, for some reason it worked weird, and for a while they didn't know it was working weird, so you'd end up ahead on loot. I don't know why she just murdered that. Oh, that's a... We'll move out of that spot. But yeah, they fixed it, by the way. Billy's bar on Rocktopia doesn't work that way anymore. But no crap. When he found out how it worked, he told me, and I did do it some, right? But, I didn't have the dedication to sit in there and grind that as much as he did, for sure. Or half of the swanting stuff, in all honesty. Like, straight up. He's probably swanted more sweat than I would even want to know. Excellent player, though, guys. I'll actually even recommend him. It's Deepwater. He has a YouTube channel. I think it's under Jasper Shots, but I watch his videos sometimes. Pretty often, actually. They're all rushing me, look at that. Yeah, there's a lot of excellent players. That Zone No Shadow, by the way, he's free to play, you guys. And he's definitely a person I would consider... a good player, knows how to free to play, plays an extensive amount, not like insane, but he definitely gets his play in, and he is free to play. In fact, he streams, or no, he does what you call it, YouTube, and excellent YouTuber, but. He produces more videos on, like, he doesn't, like, you know how I YouTube my gameplay? Like, he gameplays, right? But his videos are a actual discussion of the game, like specific things. He does much more of what almost what I would consider, like, almost like a film review type almost method. You know, I'm not a production type expert, so I don't know what method would to call it, but he's good at it. Man, Man, there's some really good people that do Entropy, actually, guys. We got all those missiles. I hope those guys are having a blast with all that stuff. Okay. Real quick, I'm gonna head back here. We're gonna take care of stuff. I know one of my big plans is definitely to do more yoga this year. That stuff's so good for you. And honestly, I was kind of lazy about my own personal, like, development stuff on that front this year. This last year. This year, we're going to be freaking epically on it. And so, that's a good thing. But last year, I feel maybe I allowed myself to be stagnant on personal development on some aspects of things. In which there's no point in that, right? Yeah, I should have gave those guys some food. Okay. Just trying to get this stuff over into the other box so it won't be taking up. Guys, we have to start using a plasma wipe weapon. I have 20-something plasma cores. Literally no reason for that crap. What we have? Not enough mini nukes, though. Okay. We're getting everything moved over to its correct container so it won't have weight on this other stuff. I'm even excited about refilling that wall behind me, man. You guys have no idea. I don't know exactly what the first thing I'm going to paint up is, a little fun project. But, got to knock out a fun little paint project. Obviously, I'm going to do some pour paints and stuff like that. Honestly, I might paint the symbol for all the video game. Not on my wall, on a canvas, guys. I mean, just gonna be honest. But, yeah, super excited about that. I like to bust out art once in a while. It refreshes your soul, guys. Even if you're not good necessarily at art, it doesn't matter. Literally is. You could paint stick figures on a thing and put it up on a wall, it'll look cool, guys. Doesn't matter all our other stuff. I don't like that Tunnel of Love one that much. but I am looking for us to have some kind of... I'm removing the squatters from this place. I don't even know who the squatters are, but we're going here. Yeah. It's a super relaxing one. And, in all honesty, there's like, where I live, there's a place called The Palette. And you basically go there on dates and stuff like that. And they, you don't have to be good at painting. But basically, they give you wine. And somebody that does know how to really paint, paints and shows you how to paint stuff. And then you kind of, like, paint it also with them. Freaking epic, epic thing to go do with somebody, guys. I'm going to let you know. Very fun. Chill, chill. Whoop. These squatters are going down fast. I'm gonna assume he's upstairs. This is like a store. Okay, guys, look at this place. Let's really look at this. A little house. You got shelves right here. I feel we just murdered the runners of a poor innocent store. Well, I obviously didn't get everybody. Hold on, let's find out who else is shooting at us. Okay, we're gonna go deeper into this area. Let me figure out where we're going exactly. They nuked my camp, guys. I'm not gonna kick on camp 12 because it's under nuclear radiation and stuff. This, though, we can do this. Gulper Horde, boom, right there. Bullcrap, I am not over. Okay, guys, hold on 1 second. They're always trying to mess us over on the over-encumbered stuff. Do you guys see that pond? This is the kind of fishing pond I like to go to, right here. If I lived here, I'd be fishing right here, guys. That's good fishing. You just chill right, I mean, like, it's in a radiation zone, so probably not as chilly as I'd want it to be. They know that we're trying to make it somewhere. Guys, we're gonna make it there, don't worry. We're stirring up stuff today. Am I where we're supposed to be? Yeah, the golfer group. That's where I'm supposed to be. Okay, so look at these guys. Hey, thank you very much. I hope you have a great day at work, by the way. Okay, get back up. Guys, we got a 2-star black powder pistol. Wait, what are they talking about? How are they just throwing me in another... What is she just talking
make sure
about?
You bring a lot of bullets. That big alpha is a heap of trouble.
Wait, that's all the way over there. You guys, they are like, oh, ha, ha, ha. Hold on. We've got this. Don't even worry about it. But they kind of, the way they just did that with the, hey, let's move the Alpha on the other side of the map. Okay, ready? Kill all these guys. We're killing wolves, guys. I don't know. They just threw this in here. I don't even know when we, like, committed to doing this. Okay, here's the Alpha. And why aren't we in a team? I have a team thingy, Majiggy. Or a Alpha. I don't know. Probably not the Alpha. Think they're all down? Next location. Okay, we just gotta haul butt across the map, kill some more wolves. Is it an amount of time? Jeez, why would they make it an amount of time thing? I like how they call the one disease ear snot, you know what I mean? Because you pretty much know what's going on. Some kind of oozy ear thing going on. That's what I assume, right? It's gross, though. And that would suck and be a massive disadvantage in a situation like this. Just going right here. Run in there. We don't have to run there. Yeah, it's gonna be a good year. I looked, most of the games that I'm waiting for them to come out, they don't come out till later on in the year, to be honest. It kind of shocked me. So, guys, I'm gonna just tell you, I've been waiting for both Nightingale and Starfield to come out for a while, and they kicked back Starfield, and they still haven't announced the date on Nightingale at all. And so supposedly this year, but you know, until it's actually out, who knows? But I am super excited about that. It'll be way later. And then I'll have to rework our exact schedule for stuff. I don't know exactly how we'll lay it out, but... Oh, look at this pack, guys. I don't know if that guy knows, but I'm trying to do something here. Okay. Oh! This is its own little thing right here, guys. Cause that's an alien. Where'd he go? Oh boy, he's turned invisible. And invincible. So I don't know what to do there, so. When I can't do anything to them, I just leave them alone. It's a standard rule, actually. You're like, where am I gonna go with that? So, like, at that point, we're gonna figure out how to make it back to over here. If all of a sudden I start getting attacked by him out of nowhere, because all of a sudden he magically is tracking us, and I don't know. You know what? If it happens, we'll deal with it. Not even gonna be a big deal. I like this confidence level though. It was highly confident there, right guys? Okay, everybody's down. I'm gonna tell you, this road was seriously busy heading up to the vault, huh? That'll blow that up instantly. I gotta watch with that, guys. I was going to pretend to extricate somebody from a car. Just poof. Isn't it neat that they had, like, most of the other vaults were kind of secretive-ish, but this one is just like, Vault 76. So 2076 around October is when, in theory, this nuclear event happens, huh? Oh, it's a frog. Oh, this is the one dude's little house where he's always being attacked by ticks.
Sonny makes a good hoagie.
Mm-hmm. We're almost down now, guys. That's the sawmill right there. Across the road is the One People's Farm. Guys, I'm super excited for the day. Okay. Juggernauting right along. Whoa. I'm gonna be honest, I'm not a fan of the ticks either. The ticks, the mosquitoes, basically any bug that wants to suck my blood out, not a fan of at all. Just, yeah. Actually, not even any bug. Basically, most things that I could imagine that would want to suck my blood up, I'm probably not a big into that. I mean, sure, everybody has a vampire fetish, but, you know, I'm just joking. But for real, basically most people do. They're like, hey, if I met a vampire, I don't know I would actually resist. Just saying. I mean, I know that those aren't real, but you know what I'm saying. If the fictional thing did exist, I think most of humanity would not resist. We'd be like, oh yeah, we'll still jump to that. Maybe not though, maybe I'm wrong. Who knows? If they're like the Hollywood glorified, like, you know, sexified version of vampires, of course. Not if they're like Gangrel type. Nobody's into the Gangrels, I don't think. Who knows? Maybe that's somebody's cup of tea. But I think that basically, yeah. About to be epic year. I really do need to actually burn up some of this ammo. So I'm gonna have to pick a gun that we're gonna spray some rounds out of. Guys, these holiday gifts we're gonna have to open up. I have way too many of them. I don't even know what the purpose of them is, but people, huh? That's it. We're making a new weapon. Crap, guys. Why? What are we doing? Are they trying to say that we're in a zone of some mission? We want these rad stacks. Rag stacks are really good for carry capacity. Honestly, they moved our rad stag like herd. I don't know why they did it, but basically where the rad stack herd was out in the radiation zone, it's not spawning there anymore. And for a long time, that was how I got myself around. Now we're at the whims of stuff. Okay. I'm gonna build a new weapon though, I can tell you that. Okay, we're gonna sell that to the thing. This is why we're so overweight. Okay, now I don't know why that was just creepy. Beat the people. And back the beat in one zone. Guys, I'm trying to get through this, so here's what I'm gonna do. When I go to this one, we're going to knock it out. I don't know what feed the people is, so let's look at this. Collect ingredients and crap. Protect the machines. I'm going to protect machines and repair them. I think I can do that. Come on, let me move.
Mama Dolce's have finally cooled down enough to work again. I set them up to make Kansas stew using the ingredient container right around the factory. The machines make a hell of a racket, so you'll probably get some unwanted guests.
He just fell out of the sky, guys. Where's the flavored meat, guys? Where's these robots, too? Can I tell you, I hear a robot up here. I'm gonna just head up here to try to find him and kill him. Oh, there's glowing meat. This is probably what I'm supposed to shove in there, huh? No. Well, what goes in the hopper, guys? Soy? These robots. I'll kill all the robots. The people that know where everything is can do the other stuff. Ah! Boom! We got it, guys! Okay, so somebody else... These guys are stressing me out. It says we're supposed to protect these, but mine's not being attacked, you guys. Where are my people? Okay, I'm glad you're back. There it is. My zone isn't being attacked right. Something's attacking my hopper, but I can't see it. How is something getting my ingredient hopper, guys? Okay, I'm gonna get grenades on me too. Well, where's the pressure valve? I don't know where the pressure valve is. Ooh! A nuke will get most things for sure. Wait, are they like upstairs attacking my thing? Okay. Guys, they were up here getting it. I'm gonna shut this door. Oh, it's not a shuttable door. So see, now I've got my hopper under control now. I'm gonna tell you, that echo that they've got there is absolutely well done. Just sounds good. Sometimes I wonder, like, where they get some of the sound effects. You know how they can digitally fake things now, image-wise? My wonder is, can they actually make audio digital? Like, can they just CGI is sound, basically, you know what I'm saying? Are these guys attacking my thing again? Okay. I don't know who's blowing everything up, but I'm trying to get to a pipe. Go, dude, go. So guys, this is a little bit of work, this one. I'm gonna just assume whoever's throwing grenades up there is timing it good, because we're not seeing a lot of enemies. Oh, thank gosh this is complete. That was a long mission, you guys. Treasury notes and such. Okay, we're going in here and we're finding an automated signal, guys. Okay, let's just grab everything, right? Hey guys, at this point, I think I have enough fuel that we could use our flamethrower. I don't even know what we're supposed to be doing here. Oh, okay. Power up the automated research terminal, huh? How are we supposed to do that? Is the automated research terminal here? Yeah. Here's our pick a lock even. Maybe. Oh, good. I guess I have the DNA. What is this place? The right place. Okay. It looks like somebody just came through here, guys. By the way, thank you for letting me know that, too. close. Oh. Okay. I'm guessing crappy today, obviously. Just gonna let you guys know. By guessing, this is why I don't like going out and risking too much for guests. Okay, well. Ah, good. No, it's always, you know what? That's the thing that also shocks me. This game, I've been playing a little bit now, right? I mean, we all know that I've got enough episodes that you would think that we had run out of things to learn. And yet, still, I literally get told stuff all the time that I'm like, oh. Just an interesting game. There's a huge amount of stuff in here. Kind of crazy. Okay, so now what? I just need to go kill a scorch beast? Oh. Oh, no, I need to go get one. Okay, so let me go get one real quick. That's not that hard. I like Scorch Beast hunting. We're about to go pick a big fight. Get myself all adjusted for this. Oh yeah, now we're going to go kick the crap out of a Scorch Beast now that I think of it. Let me get us weight down. I like Scorch Beast. That's why we're overran on so much some supplies, just to be honest. They're fun to fight. They'll pour that little army of dudes on you sometimes. They're actually, can I be honest? The Scorch Beast is one of the cooler mobs that they added to this. Like, I like the Deathclaw and the Behemoth and stuff like that from previous Fallouts. But I'm going to let you know that the Scorch Beast, awesome. They absolutely need more mobs like that in future games. For sure. Like that was a solid mob. Up in the air, it acts like you want it to act pretty much. Sometimes they get a little glitchy and they're like falling from the sky 1,000 times in a row. But, I mean, outside of that, mob-wise, it's a well-thought, well-done mob. Like, that's one of the ones they actually did a good job on. You know, I don't know. Every game does a hit and miss on some mobs. But once in a great while, they'll create some new creature within their game that you're like, nah, that's a solid freaking creature. And Scorch Beast, they're definitely a solid creature. Well done on that one. Oh! No, I don't know where that is. I mean, I might have found it, but I don't know. Yeah. But I do like watching people do get out. That's actually one of the things I really enjoyed about Fallout 4. Is how many random fights you would come across. Jeez, this place came alive with hate. Oh! That's absolutely a good idea. Yeah. Interesting. So, no, I don't know where that is, but I will have to check it out and find out where it is. That's not a bad idea, though. It's absolutely a good idea. I like how people come up with just such creative ways to approach such a similar thing. You know what I mean? And I see channels doing all kinds of different stuff. And I've looked over other people's channels. I like to look over stuff. But I'm going to tell you, I'm fascinated at how people approach things. Just one of the most amazing things. People will sit there and you think that you have a rational, like, mind that's coming at things in a similar direction. And then you literally visit with more and more people and find out that, my God, people are coming at this game in so many directions. That's absolutely profound. I think it's profound. I absolutely think it's neat, too, though. Okay, guys. Anybody need a lab coat for some reason? Like, you... Oh, I believe it. So, those bears have been responsible for killing me in a lot. So, I'm going to tell you what... I dreaded the bears when it was in Fallout 4 in Far Harbor, because in the fog, multiple times I would not see them, and they'd hit me from the side, boom, wound me immediately, then all of a sudden you're limping like a gimp, and they took you down. I think the bears in that game are absolutely well done. I mean... Real bears are probably more powerful, maybe not, I don't know. I don't go messing around with trying to pick fights with bears for sure. But I do think that they've done just a fabulous job with them in this game. The fact, Fallout 4 though, I'm gonna let you know, I got hit by the side. I feel that they were much sneakier in Fallout 4, just for the record, you guys. Okay, my camp is still in the radiation zone, which is really frustrating. I don't know what to do about that. So what we're going to do... Oh, I would try to keep them away too. I'm going to just be honest. There's no way I think I'm wanting to mess with a bear. I live in Colorado. I see them sometimes, not very often, because I live not out in the middle of nowhere. I live in a pretty urban place. It's not, well, not that urban, but it's Colorado. It's a minor city, you know what I mean? And so we have bears around the area, but not in town most of the times. By the way, our edges of town, once in a while... do actually have bears just come wandering into town, but we're much more likely to have a deer or something like that come wandering into town than a bear, just to be honest. And so, oh yeah, and in 99% of conditions, nobody has a problem with bears, I'm saying, but you do need to be aware of them. Like, if I go hiking up in the mountains, I don't, like, think, oh, I'm the biggest, coolest thing in the mountain. I mean, it is very, very apparent that bears will kick your butt. But in all honesty, most of the time when I've seen a bear, it was heading high tail, like, away into the woods, not like... I've never actually seen a bear rush somebody or some crap. I mean, like, except on TV and stuff. But honestly, though, guys, I'm not an avidly out there all the time in bear country. In fact, honestly, if I figure out an area seriously, like, competitively bear country, I'm not the biggest, hey, this is where I should be person, so. Okay, we're gonna get a gun so we can take down the Scorch Beasts. That'll be fun. Oh! Well, I'm jealous of you. That's pimp, dude. That's absolutely awesome. I see, I wish I had a whole bunch of acres of forest land. And I would pay attention to for bears if I did have that. That is insane cool, though. Okay, this is what we're going with. And then I'm going to have to get us down somehow. I'll just eat a bunch of food, guys. That's what we're going to do. Okay. I probably should just destroy the scalper innards. Oh, those ads, they nail people all the time. Thank you for hanging out during them, though. Okay, so here's the plan. We've got our gun. We have grilled rad stacks, so we have the ability to travel. Yeah, I'm cooking pretty much everything we can cook up to XP up, and because I needed to get rid of the weight. Okay, so we have our Gatling gun. We have 8,000 rounds of ammo. We don't need 8,000 rounds of ammo. Okay, let's go with... That's enough. We'll be fine, guys. What we're going to do is we're going to use a rad stag and stuff like that. I'm going to get this guy his sleep real quick. I'm going to grab some more coffee, and then we're going directly down to start killing Scorch Beasts. Okay. It is. I feel anytime he's about to go down. Boom. There, we're good. We're ready to travel. And we're down south. Now we're gonna tear things up. I'm going to tell you guys. We're going to sell some of that stuff here too. The meat. Because I'm going to get a bunch of stuff down here. This southern area, guys, is XP heavy. It's a little bit of the hard fight stuff. But overall, this area is just so good for leveling up.
ready to exchange items.
Okay. We want that. I probably should be using that, but we're gonna sell it.
Now displaying current stock.
I don't know why I'm sneezing like that this morning, but holy. Deep breath there. I was legitimately not seeing the vampire weapon. Reload. Yeah, the queen is ridiculous. Good fight. Okay, guys, there's one over this direction. I'm gonna probably use that grilled rad stag at this point. Okay, that should kick us into a good zone. Hope nobody nukes us while we're down here. Oh my gosh. Yeah. No. 100%. I can see how that happened though, because if he doesn't know how to put it in and stuff like that, that's insane. That's kind of, well, he got an awesome deal out of it. I mean, I guess it's not probably hilarious to you, but I would have never thought of that as this is going to be the issue. Nah, I would want to watch the football game on that. That's the way to do it, though, is to recess it into your wall. That thing's coming at me. I did not do that for any of the TVs in my house, but honestly, I wish I did now. Whoa, guys! He just tossed me. Holy crap. Why did I throw my bomb all the way over there? Did you see that? Oh, at least you're the liked son-in-law, man. I'm gonna tell you. Oh, yeah, I saw that. We're good on that. I'm gonna kill this guy real quick. He just got me because I wasn't paying attention. Did I get that other creature? No. Okay. We take out that king so we don't get distracted on the side. Okay, the king's down. Oh, I gotta move real quick. Ah, crap, crap, crap. I got hemmed up, guys. I didn't do that as smooth as I thought I was gonna. We've got her. We just cannot get caught up like that, or like drop on the ground. I don't know if I do, but I have a giant gun that. No, I don't think I. Maybe I have. I honestly don't know. We finished out most of the missions though, so. Okay, he's down. That's down. Yeah, nah, he hits hard. Let's do this way. Okay, guys. We've got this girl. I'll obviously have to grab some more ammo real quick, but why is it? I thought we grabbed 5,000 rounds or something, but. What is heavy PA? Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'm not set up right, but I don't know. Usually the normal ones, that stuff rips right through anyway. I can hear the little guys in the grass, you know what I mean? Okay, we're gonna go right back here, and then I'm gonna get obviously more ammo. I really thought we grabbed like thousands of ammo, guys, didn't we? I mean, like, maybe I misinterpreted what we grabbed. I must have misinterpreted what I thought I grabbed, honestly. That's okay. Okay, we're gonna take out the power patcher for 1 second. Oh, did I just take out the wrong thing? Yeah, I did. What the crap am I thinking? Sorry, guys. We're gonna take out White Knight for a second. Then come down here. Oh! It's okay, we're gonna have a ton. Okay, now we have enough ammo for sure for a second. Oh, I get you. I'll bet it is. If I set it up like an ammo smith actual character, that's absolutely not a bad idea. I haven't used my extra builds yet. Well, I did use one and I totally messed it up. So then I told myself, nah, don't touch that crap till you know what you're gonna do. You know what I'm saying? And so at this point I have builds to build the guy into, but I really was so disappointed with what I did with the first build that I didn't want to build a build until I like knew exactly what I was doing. But I have two actual slot things that have not been messed up yet. I just wanted to save them until I had an idea of what would be the best. You know what I mean? So I used one of my builds way early on. And it was when I didn't actually know the game well enough. And I don't know what I was thinking, but basically I did just a crappy job on it. It doesn't make sense as a build, you know what I'm saying? And so then as soon as I did that, I'm like, well, just don't use any of those until you know what you actually want. I should be approaching one of the craters, guys, right here. There's fissures all over out here. On top of that, these forests, they're cool. They have stuff going on. There's a goat dude or whatever. Look at that. Da-da-da. Legendary, noxious, not goat man, sheep squatch. Oh yeah, 100%. That is, I get why that would make sense. We did just see the sheep squatch here, right? I know we did. He's up in there, guys. He's tough though, see? That sheep squatch ramming thing though should almost kill me, guys. You know it. I feel that these dudes would know that they were in trouble right here. Okay, so let's sell some more stuff. Then you know what? Let's just be overweight for a second. I know, and that totally gimps you sometimes. You'll be in the middle of sawing and all of a sudden, and it just cuts out on you. Honestly, the other week I replaced my batteries in my, like, mouse, because I thought it was cutting out because of batteries. Because I've had that happen, guys. But I'm legitimately not sure that it wasn't just that I was hitting AP cap and just killing out. Like, I'm just going to be honest. Hey, thank you very much, by the way, and welcome. But yeah, the saws are awesome until you don't pay attention to that and you run up on something and you're like, what the crap? But last week, I legit thought there was some kind of glitch going on or something. Who lives there?
You don't think the Edge Psycho gives you is worth it, huh?
You want to devolve into a rabid dog? Suit yourself. You can find new company then, too.
Oh, these guys are having some kind of fight about somebody's addiction issues. I don't know what's up with that, but that their battle buddiness is too close. No, I know their BOS. But did you hear him talking about the use of stuff? That girl definitely seemed like she was, you know, I don't know, gripey. I really love these forests. Honestly, I know that there's no trees like this in the real normal. Well, maybe there are. I'm not a tree expert. But as far as I know, I don't think that there's trees specifically like this. But if there are, man, that'd be definitely a neat forest. Cherry blossom trees are pretty though, too. That's one of the things that I think that they did good on this and all the fallouts. The sceneries are super sweet sceneries. The radiation is gone, guys. So now we really are about to dominate. So we're heading to Camp 12 right now. Camp 12. Oh, I get you. Whoa, where did that come from? I like trees. Yeah. I'll tell you what. And I'm sure it's the same where you guys live, but during fall color change season, people legit, and I go up there too, the mountains up here in Colorado are freaking epic looking. Like, just like, I love it. It's a pretty neat thing to see. Oh, yeah. That makes sense. I'm like, I don't know why they would just hand us a Gatling gun out of nowhere, out randomly, you know. Okay, are we at the bottom of the map? We are. We're heading to Camp 12. It's right over in the area. We have everything we need for doing this. I even had forgot why we were down here, actually, somehow already. That's kind of ridiculous, but look at this. We've got one thing right here. I'm not collecting the Ultra Sight today. Unless one of you guys needs Ultra Sight, then I would collect it for you guys. But at this point, I'm so Ultra Sighted up, it's... That was probably a little ridiculous. I think I'm almost to Camp 12, guys. And the problem with Camp 12 is, if we try to appear there, what they like to do is put us on the other side of the out of bounds fence, and then tell us repetitively that we're out of bounds. Yeah. Okay, other side of the forest. So this forest is good XP sometimes, especially right after a nuking. I'm going to tell you why. There's going to be some serious creatures in here. We might have a Scorch Beast come up right here too, by the way. We're at a fissure. Don't worry, guys. There will be Scorch Beasts. Besides that dead one on the ground. And we won't be overweight, because I actually have a camp down here. It just... Okay, now moving on. Okay, so worst case scenario, we go into the glass cavern. That's not a worst case scenario, because the glass cavern is actually one of my favorite things to farm, just to be honest. But you always guaranteed get a Scorch Beast in glass cavern. It's the 100%. But there's one anyway. See? Look at it. We're trying to get over to my Camp 12 area anyway. I'll spawn it after, but... I'm gonna take out these dudes on me. Now! It's ours! That is the last thing a Scorched Beast wants to do. Dead. We've got our sample. Okay, so we do have a sample, but because we're down here, we're going for big. Look at where we are. Okay, Camp 12. They have jacked up my Camp 12, guys. My Camp 12's damaged. Camp 12's in trouble, it looks like. Okay. This gives us a second. We get to sit here and drop off whatever we need to. No, we did not grab our rounds. Look at all these guns. Okay, back on it. Okay, we're gonna get Camp 12 out of here because this place gets nuked, guys. That's the only reason, honestly. Camp 12, though, is a huge benefit down here. And so, do end up using it a lot. We're going right here. Okay, so if you were looking for that ultra stuff, what ultra site, you would come in here or out there actually, but there's actually a bunch of ultra site inside of this building, in this cave or cavern or whatever, you know what I mean? It's like a mine, cavern, whatever, nuclear place. It's actually pretty easy to move through. At the end, it spawns a Scorch Beast. I know we already have one, but we're down here, so let's get another, right? I like the XP we get off of them. Plus, I like killing Scorch Beasts. Normally, there's dudes somewhere around here. I don't know where the guards are. I assume somebody has walked through here and wiped on things or something. Yeah, the guards are gone. Doesn't matter. When we get to the end, it'll just spawn a Scorch Beast at us. You come up this way. This way over to the side, there's dudes sometimes. Normally, honestly, it's not those guys, though. Usually it's Scorched or robots, but not the communist robots. Okay, now we're here. Okay, those guys are down. I got myself in an awkward little spot right there for some reason. I'll be honest, I don't know if I were in a power suit, I would just trust some sticks across the chasm to not drop my butt. Okay. I'm gonna hope they come after me. This is one of the easier, hey, you can just run through this baby. If I threw grenades down there, I'd be hitting stuff. But basically only these guys anyway. Come on. Okay guys, now we're there. I'm gonna let our AP recharge because that's actually being annoying on us. See, look, there's our friend right there. Da-na-na. Doesn't she look angry? I'll be honest. Da-da-da-da. There, now she's seeming angry. I don't know why she's sticking on her source like that, though. Okay, guys, they're about to do a game shutdown. Because they like to do this at me. I don't know whether whoever's shooting at us is. He's stuck. This isn't even gonna be the same. I feel I've cheated. Ah, he's unstuck himself. Good. Cause I legit felt bad about that. We got Lieutenant whatever her name's ID. I don't know why we would get that, but. We now own that. Okay, going straight up. Now we're rolling. We've got our DNA. They're trying to shut down the server on us. It's Monday. I don't know if they know that. Oh, deja vu right here, guys. That's how it works right there. We felt like we had walked out that door, but no. Okay, round two. Oh yeah. Yeah, that's worked out for you guys. See how they're trying to get us shut down? I feel like we're just trying to get our guy powered up, and they're all like, hey, let's shut down the server on you. It's okay. Every day we end at 7 anyway, guys. So it's not like they're really shutting us down massively early. Some glitchy stuff is going on, though. I've noticed a few things weird so far this morning. So maybe they actually do need to shut down the server today for a minute. Well, I'm gonna be honest, I didn't do whatever that was. That somebody blew up something over there though. Oh, I like this little place. Sometimes cool stuff is here. I'm going to swap to EU later today. I am going to actually be on EU. I have to do some work stuff for a second. And then I'm going to be back on. And I'm going to be on EU. I'm super excited about that for today. Who is blowing up stuff? I don't understand. What all's getting blown up around me, but I don't like that countdown thing. I know that I should be thankful for it, because it's probably really helpful to make sure we don't get distracted and stuff. But I don't know why that little ticky tick sound. I'm not a big fan of it. I mean, it makes me feel we're on some kind of mission timer, is why I think. To where you like, you know, there's some kind of countdown going on. Besides the fact that there is a real countdown going on, you know what I'm saying? Okay, we're almost there. Got our DNA. This area down here, though, is an excellent area for stuff. Okay, so this one we're getting rid of. Do you guys feel that sound, like, makes you feel like we're under some kind of mission countdown? I sure do. I'm going to get rid of some of this stuff that we're never going to use.
Ready to exchange items.
Okay, now I'm going to show you why we have plenty of ability to travel, even with us being all overweight like this. So if you don't know, during this whole Nuka-Cola World event, the little place there sells these Yogi pastries. They have a 60 carry weight boost to them, and you can just buy them. And then on top of that, we are going to eat our Deathclaw steak. Yeah, just like that, we're a beast, and we can just carry stuff wherever we want. Okay, we're going back to our place. I'm getting us claimed on that one quest real quick before they get this thing shut down is the plan. Well, he's dead. My house will kill most people. So much XP just from doing that every time. It adds up, guys. Slowly but surely, all that stuff adds up. And we need the stakes. We all see that, right? I wouldn't be able to travel anywhere without that crap. Okay. I'm gonna make sure they didn't damage my house with all that shooting. They damaged a berry. Okay, we're gonna drop off our high-powered minigun. Drop off all ammo. Are any of you guys actually using any of these guns where you could use that ammo? Now, where am I supposed to go back to? Okay, boom. I couldn't remember where we were trying to get to. And I'm watching that little countdown timer. I'm going to actually shut down a little bit before it. Just because I worry that... Well, just because, honestly. I don't trust the little countdown timers to actually remember everything. I don't like server shutdowns. Playing in their zone is not my cup of tea. I do get that they have to shut down servers though, okay? So I'm not like, oh, they should never do that. It just, I've had glitches happen on server shutdowns where like multiple times the stuff that I did between the announcement and wasn't there. And in space, in Entropia Universe, I freaking had a server shut down one time where it literally just went weird. Basically, I was in space and they shut down the planets. One of the planets. And I'm going to let you know, I got stuck not being able to dock at the shutdown. It wasn't a huge deal, but you know what I'm saying. Okay, so what did we do? Was this like an actual main quest I hadn't done? I'm trying to interpret what just happened. Oh, it's a daily. Okay. I'm like, I thought we had all main quests done, guys, but that makes sense. A daily would make much more sense. There's too many dailies in here. I mean, not there's actually not too many. So there's a lot of dailies in here. I'm going to watch how I say things so it's not in the negative verse, you know, because it's not that there's too many. It's just there's so many that it's actually hard to know all the missions for this game, which is absolutely impressive. Okay, guys, taking us here. We got a little bit before the shutdown. I'm going to actually take that minute to get coffee and actually have a pretty relaxing day before I have to get around to work for the day. Before, though, I'm going to get us back to our place. We're going to find somebody that is doing Fallout 76. Ah, no, I'm not. I'm not going to transfer you guys to somebody for Fallout 76 because the servers are about to shut down. And that would make zero sense to do to you guys, right? Okay, so that's not what's going to happen. I'm going to be transferring to somebody playing Entropia Universe, honestly, guys. Because server shutdowns kind of make it pointless to transfer to somebody that's playing something else. And so, it's just going to be a server shutdown in 1 minute. And so it wouldn't even make any sense. And so, hold on 1 second. Let me pull this up. By the way, yeah, I'm gonna take it over to, it looks like Bella's playing right now, is what I'm seeing. I'm going to check this out. Oh, I would raid Bambi. Let me look up Bambi real quick. Found him. On it right now. So you guys, I hope you have an amazing day. This year is going to be epic for all of us. We're all going to make that way. So send positive vibes at each other. Do whatever it takes. But let's all be epic as crap. Knock off big goals this year and such. And so you guys kick off this year, right? Peace, very best wishes, and I hope you have an amazing day.